You can do this, Luke. Just gotta believe you can.
You fight harder than those other guys, and you win.
Come on, Louie!
Keep pushing!
Come on, Lou.
We're not dying!
You are nothing. Come on. Come on. Unbroken, now playing rated PG-13.
Now to the power of dance. Sheinelle has the story of one family that's hoping to take wheelchair ballroom dancing to a higher level here in the U.S.
Yes, this is a good story. So dancing, as we all know, is a great form of exercise and fun. And when you're dancing on wheels, it's even more physically and mentally exhilarating. And once Elaina Cardenas got started, she couldn't get enough. 12-year-old Elaina Cardenas loves ballroom dancing.
The costumes, the thrill you get when you're, like, performing for people, and, like, the wind going through your hair when you're spinning really fast. Just the entire experience is really cool.
It was a dream her parents never thought would come true.
I'm going to get emotional now thinking about it, but going off of what you see when she was born and you try to project what her life is going to be like, what are her struggles going to be, but she just does whatever she wants to do.
Elaina was born with spina bifida, a birth defect that results in abnormalities in the spine.
And that affects mobility and different muscles. It kind of varies as to where their level of paralysis and their level of mobility is.
But that hasn't stopped Elaina.
She can walk with crutches. She's very athletic. There's really nothing that she doesn't do. She did horseback riding, she swims, wheelchair basketball.
And now she's taking up wheelchair ballroom dancing, inspired by Dancing with the Stars, even meeting one of the judges.
Before I was kind of like, oh yeah, it looks like fun. And then when I met Tony Devolani, it's like, I want to do this.
An email to the American Dance Wheels Foundation led her family to the Dance Art Project in Connecticut.
Place this hand this way. Okay. And then this way.
The sport is gaining ground in other countries.
It's very popular in Latin America and Europe. It's called wheelchair dance sport, and I know they have national championships out there.
The Cardenas family is hoping to gain more ground here in the U.S., spreading the word about wheelchair ballroom dancing.
What it does for these kids, both physically, the regimen, the workout, to get stronger and build strength, is immeasurable. What it does for them emotionally, they're dancing and they're performing in front of people and they're getting applause, and it just gives them a whole new sense of I'm doing something really great and something really special.
And then in the end, when people are clapping, how does that feel?
Amazing. Like, I just climbed Mount Everest.
If you focus on abilities rather than disabilities, mm-hmm. It's just a more positive way to view the world. There's no limits. You can do whatever.
Raphael is hoping to make ballroom wheelchair dancing a part of the Paralympics. And there's an effort to get more dance instructors certified in wheelchair ballroom dancing across the country. American Dance Wheels recently conducted a study among veterans who do wheelchair ballroom dancing and found it has greatly helped them with post-traumatic stress. I have to tell you, I am forever changed by this young lady. We did the, you know, when I danced with her. First of all, it's exercise for you, too. You know, you're moving your arms. But the things that you're able to do, and I'm amazed her partner was able to pick her up and spin her around.
But the lessons learned for us, for and everybody. What a great moment when they say you focus on your abilities rather than your disabilities.
Right, exactly.
That's really what it's all about.
I walked away with that message.
Incredible.
Absolutely. Let's see. And
look
hopefully
at that. I hope it makes it into the Paralympics.
Look at that. Move. And they say it's good for her because it's pulling her. It's pulling her straight, pulling her spine.
Her upper body power. She was knocking out those push-ups. She did like 10 in that 1 second. I would have been toast after one in the whole day.
So it's a win-win.
The way music makes you feel also to be out there and moving to it.
Or think you're never going to get the feeling of when they applaud for you, that you're not you're capable of getting that feeling, but you are.
Bravo.
Anything's possible.
And her parents, of course, moved to tears.
Great, thank you.